Yeah, I completely agree with you. EVH obviously looking fantastically well. And you were talking about Gotoki as a tracer main. Hitman, also a fantastically good tracer. When I casted without you, I think it was last week?
Yeah, the week before that.
I got the pleasure of seeing Gotoki and Hitman tracer off, basically, for a good 40 minutes, and it was beautiful. They were switching between Widowmaker and Tracer, and they were just kind of playing against each other, and it was so beautiful, and they were showing up so, so well. So Hitman, a character, someone I want to keep my eye on. Really good, like, really flexible player, capable of playing quite a few things. EVH, realistically, I think are probably the favorites to win this, but New Kings, I mean, I actually haven't casted them, unfortunately, due to a couple of issues in my own internet connections and not being able to be here online. I didn't really get to cover any of this stuff, so you'll have to kind of give me the breakdown on New Kings here and kind of let me know what your kind of expectations are and who the players are meant to be looking out for. For anyone who's new to the stream as well, who should they be watching on the side of New Kings?
I really like Blue Hawk and Null. It's always easy to go with the DPS place. Oh, we already have a pause, so that's nice. That means we can talk about this for a second.
Gets a kill as well.
Well, on the side of EVH, it's like everyone on that team can come up big. So in that regard, there's not too much to say.
Yeah.
I really like that Johnny is going with a Winston here. So because of that, I'm just going to go with him for this specific game. In general, I don't feel like New Kings has a very clear, they don't have someone like Savage Beast, who's not necessarily always the greatest play, but has a very strong personal style of play.
Yeah.
They just have a pretty regular set of plays, nothing that really springs to mind right this instant. So I think it's just straight up going to be which team is, able to run their competition better. I really love May. We haven't seen a May all night, which I'm very sad about. She's pretty hard to play, so it's understandable, but at the same time, May is
such
a fun
character.
She's
so good on defense as well.
Yeah,
she's such
a man. It's the same as with Torbjörn, right? Like, once you're really able to set up, some blizzards and you're able to keep splitting the enemy team, it's just so strong. And Zenmu's playing her so aggressive as well.
I'm actually seeing Blue Hawk get straight onto the point, and he's
Johnny
at the back, so
he's gonna get the first tick, isn't he?
Skinny British girl and a monkey at the back there. Hitman is actually gonna take Blue Hawk down straight away though, so do manage to return that back, say, nope, get off our point, we wanna hold this. Gunvelt may be that kind of version of Savage Beast I was kind of see from the last series, a lot more tempered, kind of more of a consistent player, as you see him just land a fantastic charge forward onto Falcon Wind, and Soulkiller manages to pick the kill up as well there. So yeah, I feel Gunvelt is what I want out of Savage Beast, just like a more consistent player.
Yeah, but I mean, we saw that Savage Beast knows how to do it. It's like the last 10 minutes he was playing out of his mind.
Yes, yeah, and Beast. Maybe he was just being cocky. Maybe it was just the cockiness, and he just wanted to play around a bit because he felt confident. But that's what I liked out of him. He did really well. Falcon Wind actually charged Zambu. Well, she doesn't get the Earth Shatter onto multiple members. Falcon Wind gets nil, takes that gun out, and that's 3 kills coming, 4 kills coming through. Blue Hawk picks one up, and EVH just get dropped on the base, and now we're gonna see Hitman hop down into Blue Hawk's hands, and he just drops him out as well. Fantastic team fight coming from EVH.
I am very surprised by this turn of events, because
yes,
Johnny went in and he just got blown up. But because he got blown up, the enemy team or EVH Redder wasn't really ready for Falcon Wind's Earth Shatter, and that Earth Shatter, just straight up like won them the game. The fact that Falcon Wind is able to hit Zambu with a charge, that's the only way you like insta-kill Mei, right? She's always just gonna ice block. So yeah, great start for them.
Well, that's actually gonna be the blizzard come down, as we're gonna see Zambu go down straight the way Asterix gets himself one as well. So it's a 1-for-1, and they blow the blizzard for it. So overall, actually, net gain in favor of New Kings.
Yeah,
And then Hitman gets a kill onto Blue Hawk, so completely nullifies it. But still, at first, that was a pretty good play. Zambu now has to charge that Blizzard up again, and that's so key in these big team fights to see that kind of come out.
They do have a Tranquility and Earthshatter now, so they're in a... They're not in a sensible... And what I really like...
There's the Earthshatter onto multiple members. Neil's going to get dropped by Hitman. That's going to be a couple of members come through as Hitman picks himself up a triple. Johnny does take Asterix out on the back, and he's just blinking around. Him and Bluehawk are being very aggressive on the back, but... Yeah. Unfortunately, when their team needed them, it wasn't enough. And Zambu actually snipes Johnny out.
As I was about to say, it's like, I really like Winston as a pick, but I feel like his ultimate has very limited usability in this situation.
Yes.
Like, in this specific part of this map.
That was a beautiful ice wall. It's just buying time. That's what they're doing. They're trying to burn the clock as much as possible and keep it back as far as possible, because obviously they didn't want to lose that first point. I really like that little ice wall, just blocking everyone off to let them fall back and reassess. And it's every little time you kind of buy 5 seconds, it adds up. And I say that as a massive Earthshatter lands onto multiple members. Falconwind gets himself a double kill. Johnny picks one up as well. Looks like EVH are looking for more, but Christo throws out the Transcendence, keeping his team alive, keeping them topped up. Push, however, happening in favor of New King. And you've got yourself Bluehawk on the back as Johnny throws out the Primal Rage, gets himself one. That's going to be Macarelli also with himself a kill. Gunvelt has come out of the point, but fantastic shove, fantastic ultimate coming out on the side of New Kings. Now let's have a look at the ultimates to go here. There's still quite a few ultimates in the favor of New Kings. As we see, Bluehawk, Falconwind, picked himself up 2 kills, looking for more. Neil with the tactical visor, takes out a double kill. It looks like EVH are falling apart at the seams. 1 minute 45 on the clock, and I do not think they can answer this. Asterix trying to buy time, but he cannot do so. And they get themselves up to checkpoint 2.
Man, I am super confused.
And that last turn event only cost them 2 ultimates again. Slowly, like, layering the ultimate usage. Using a couple ultimates here, get themselves a good team fight. Couple ultimates here, get themselves a good team fight. Actually, New King's doing really, really well here.
Like exceptionally well. And I'm not entirely sure, like, what is the reason. That's a nice Earthshatter.
Transcendence comes through massive, and an Earthshatter return does make it actually in the favor of New Kings. Graviton Surge lands onto multiple members. Can they actually get anyone with it? The Blizzard is there! Asterix gets the Nanogiri, gets himself 2. 4 kills in the favor of EVH. That's going to be 5. It looks like they're going for the team wipe. I think Johnny actually managed to get himself out. No, Bluehawk gets dropped right at the end. 6 kills in total. New Kings do get dropped at the end, but EVH really need to pull their trousers up. They feel like they're falling off a little bit here.
Yeah, somewhat right.
Let's see what's going to happen here. Actually, Gunvel gets stuck with a grenade. Johnny is going to try and take him out, but I don't know if it's going to be enough. It looks like they're trading across the brawl. No one's going down yet. Falconwind and Gunvel are going to be getting themselves a kill. Sound Barrier comes out as Johnny's Primal Rage is just about to time out. That's going to be a 1-for-1. Christo takes out the back line there, looking for the healers. Can they get anything else? So far, it's a 2-for-2 as Gunvel gets nano boosted. Nail takes out Hitman, but Soulkiller returns the kill. Looks like we might be done with the fight for now, as EVH do overall win the fight.
Yeah, man. The, it feels like EVH is like generally just very perplexed with what's happening. Because I feel like if they're like, I keep thinking like, okay, now they've regained themselves, right?
Okay, that was a good Earthshatter.
That looks bad.
Zambu is going to get dropped. That's 4 kills coming through. Zambu gets himself 2 kills. Sorry, he didn't get dropped. He dropped someone. Really, really well played from EVH. Suddenly they realized that actually they were teamfighting really badly and kind of a little bit all over the shot. And it feels like suddenly they're gone, oh, this is the team we were meant to be. Fantastic turn of events for them.
Very, very.
Oh! Earthshatter onto 2, and Johnny's there on the back. Can they get anyone? Neil takes that Hitman straight off the bat. Are they going to get anyone else? As Falconwind gets dropped. Transcendence is too late to save Reinhardt there. So it's a 1-for-2. 3-for-1, sorry. As they're trying to turn it through into more. Graviton Surge coming through from Soulkiller. He's trying to lay out the damage, but unfortunately, with no team to back him up, That was almost a wasted ultimate. They could have just wasted the time. 17 seconds on the clock, and the push is going in favor of the full hog is popped. Johnny gets out Christo, and now it's now down to EVH to kind of buy some time. Zambu has his ultimate available. Is gonna have to use it. Gunmetal doesn't quite have his yet, and we have got Asterix for his. So let's see how this is gonna work out. As Falcon Wind misses it, the sound barrier is gonna come out. Is the Blizzard gonna get thrown onto multiple members? Yes, it is. Gunmetal manages to land the Nerf Shadows. Hitman gets two. That's gonna be Zambu going onto more. And map one looks like we might be going all the way. 2 points captured, and that is it. But New Kings, fantastic, fantastic shove on that first round. Entirely unexpected, actually.
Yeah, man, I was like, okay, this is going to be like, I thought last game was you know, in score it wasn't close, in gameplay it was close, but you could still see that Underdogs was rather favored, but was, you know, just considering, okay, so EVH is team 3, New Kings is team 6, this is just going to be a very quick affair. But none of that actually happening. Really strong performance here from Team New Kings. And like, I'm pretty sure EVH is as perplexed as we are.
I'm kind of lost.
I know, man.
If I'm going to be honest, like, what everyone was telling me about New Kings versus EVH, I was told it's going to be a pretty easy walkover, but not the case at all. And I'm actually quite excited to see this. A team who was, they were placed 6th, I believe, or was I wrong in that, or were they lower down, versus EVH, who placed fairly high. Very exciting to see a team kind of show up this much. We did see at the end of that EVH kind of go, oh man, we played these first 2 points pretty terribly, and suddenly this team fight in Paradise Saint to show up, and suddenly all of a sudden EVH are like, oh no, actually we're quite good, really. And
we can do this. I love it. A full on dive composition. I mean, if you can argue replacing Ana with Zenyatta here, but Asphyx is such a good Ana that I'm okay with this. And this is actually something that is really good against the Mei and a Mercy. Yeah. Because Mei is good when you have like a somewhat slow push with Reinhardt, you know, you hide behind the and then you get to a certain point and then you just get dealt with the ice barrier, but none of that is going to happen with this composition because they're just going to be right on top of you.
Hitman's on Tracer. Keep your eyes on Hitman. I'm very excited to see how this is going to go. I was actually almost like, is Blue Hawk just going to hook him straight off the bat and just drop him before I can get hyped about it? A bit of a spread kind of fight coming through as we're seeing Zambu popping through and didn't actually talk too much about the fact he's picked up Genji and he just takes out the Mercy straight off the bat. Really good job there coming through from Zambu on the Genji, and Hitman just being a real nuisance. Actually very close to getting his ultimate up already. Johnny with the freezing trying to land something, but that's actually gonna be 3 kills coming through as the two people picked up. Really good ulti.
That should not have happened. Like this is again that they kind of dismantle the offense and the dive composition here, and I'm just like, what is happening?
Really, really well played from them there.
Gunfire just gets blown up, and then Zambu tries his best, and they've immediately switched off the dive composition, just going to go for a standard. I can't blame him, but I am very surprised with how that.
I mean, did die for it, but overall, completely worth it. Zambu actually takes out Mercy once again, constantly picking up this Mercy, and now we're going to see the Nano Boost go through onto Gunvale. He's going to swing the hammer. Can he find anything? No, that's going to be 2 kills coming through from the side of EVH. The full hog is popped. Johnny looking for something as we see the Blizzard land onto 2. Gunvale is going to get caught in the Blizzard. That might be him going down. A Soul Killer has got Macaroni trying to kill him. Macarelli, sorry. Christo is going to get dropped as Hitman takes himself out too. And that is going to be EVH on the point. Not quite a shot as New King, so they do have a lot to work with here. Have to get a faster push coming through, but I don't think New Kings are going to answer this push.
No. I mean, you this is where you set up, right? Like, yeah, you also have the Mercy res. You get some nice positioning going here. Surprisingly, okay.
Mercy's dead again. Yeah. The res is not charging because it feels like Mercy's constantly getting dropped. It's going to be a one for one traded here, but Hitman's actually thrown out his ultimate, so he's looking for stuff. That's going to be a good shatter, but the hook interrupts the charge as Gunbelt misses his charge, puts the shield back up, looking for more. Asterix did manage to pick up Falcon win, so fantastic hook coming through on the side of Zambu.
Can we talk
Zambu
about,
I don't really know how you want to pronounce it.
Yeah,
but
I think it's Zambu. Can we talk about Blue Hawk's Roadhawk? Because he's been underappreciated, but I feel, okay, as he gets, why does this always happen? Every single time, man, but he's been,
because he used to talk about people while they're out of position.
Yeah.
I'm trash talking. He has played very well. He's done some really good hooks, and that's the Graviton Surge onto multiple members, sucking Johnny in. Are they gonna get anyone? The Full Hook gets popped. Zambu gets himself one. Soul Killer coming up. One, the res is down. That's Zambu with a double kill. He's gonna get hooked. Can he land the hook? Yes, he can. Triple kill onto Zambu. Looking for more. Can he get anyone else's Hitman? Rockets Macarelli in the face. EVH jump. A fantastic team fight.
Yeah, this is what we kind of expected to see. However, even though they have four,
thank you.
yeah, no problem, man. Even if they have 4 minutes, it's not, you know, it's not impossible. It's going to be rather hard, but with the people randomly dying and.
Well, Hitman actually popped his ultimate for that, but EVH do manage to get themselves 2 kills, and we got to just being so irritating. Mercy this time, actually, you can see him hiding away because he just fed up of Darton dies. Okay, what you saw from Akielos?
Aklaxus.
Sorry if I'm saying that wrong. How would you pronounce that?
Aklaxus, I think.
Aklaxus. What we saw from Aklaxus was he was hiding, so if they did get team wipe again, he could res. But unfortunately, that time is not enough.
Why
the point's pushing forward, and it feels like EVH actually is just going to go through. This time, we're going to see Roadhog pop the whole hog, but the sound barrier actually is just going to be so irritating. 2 kills coming through from the side of EVH. The Mercy Res is going to come out. Can they get anything else? That's going to be Gunbelt with a double kill, a triple kill. He's looking for more than a quadra kill, and that's the cap. EVH take map one.
Okay, well, that started out as a very weird game, and as the game progressed, it kind of, you know,
EVH finally showed up as the team we expected them to be.
Okay, this is the gun. This is going to be the Gunvelt play, right?
It's like, gotta be. It's gotta be the Quadra, right?
Yeah, at the end where he gets non boosted. I mean, if it's not that, then I'm very confused. Yeah, Gunvelt didn't show. I was like, Gunvelt didn't show up until this very point. No, he was like, okay, Gunvelt, you're doing a good job.
That Mercy nice, just gave him the Quadra. You know,
like, nice, good job, man. But all jokes aside, I feel like EVH really underperformed there at the beginning. Like, not in the second round. Like, second round was all around pretty well played, pretty consistent. A little bit sloppy, but, well, I mean, I like, not sloppy, like, the dive composition just didn't work out very well for them, so they immediately switched off it, which I respect, you know. It's good to just admit, okay, we're not going to waste any more time on this. We're not going to preserve the ult charge. Just going to switch out the Winston. Switch out the Trace and just going to go and switch out the Zarya and just go with a very normal composition. All right, so that's fine.
And maybe it was just them finding their feet.
Yeah.
Potentially it was that. Maybe it was them messing around because they kind of knew that they had the. I feel like it was more them kind of finding their feet. Again, we're very late in. Finding your feet this late in can cost you. And it could have cost them quite heavily there. Fortunately, EVH do pull their trousers up and kind of fix that. But as I look towards the finals and the semi-finals and kind of into these later stages in the tournament,
can't do that.
I worry when I see stuff like this. When I see Savage Beast on the side of Underdogs playing overly aggressive and getting killed at stupid points, when I see EVH going into round one versus the team they were favored to beat quite heavily, and actually kind of falling down massively to New Kings. And I'm not just kind of saying this is EVH at fault here. I feel New Kings played fantastically well in that first round. They played that really, really well, and they knew exactly what they needed to do, kind of get their advantage. And as soon as EVH left the opening for them, that's when New Kings managed to catch in and kind of cash in on that opening. And it felt like every opening EVH left, New Kings exploited really, really well. So, first of all, props to New Kings for kind of exploiting these weaknesses and the chinks in EVH's armor, but also EVH they need to kind of cover these chinks in their armor. They need to kind of get their back kind of protected here. So maybe you kind of look into these later stages. These teams need to maybe go have a look back, have a look at these kind of VOD reviews and see, right, where did we go wrong? What was our mistakes?
Yeah, fair enough. Like, you were saying, like, there were EVH or New Kings, right, played very well. They were very good at snowballing what they were. Like, exceptionally.
Very bad at getting snowballed.
Yeah.
No, I agree with you on that point. Straight on to the point, I mean, EVH get themselves priority on the point, and Nil actually just gets himself two kills, so priority just falls straight out the window at that point, as we see Johnny also getting himself the third kill for the side of the team, and now we're seeing Hitman show up. Zambi is going to get dropped by Johnny, so Johnny got himself a double kill. Soulkiller returns one here, but it's down to Hitman just to kind of buy time at this point, which he can't do forever because he only has so many dashes and recalls on Tracer. And New Kings capture the point.
I'm just perplexed that it looks like it's happening because they had such a good position there. Like, they were in a favorable position. You know, you're already on the point. They need to move into you.
Yeah.
But then Nell picks off two people. Like, how does that even happen?
Questionable positioning. They kind of split themselves apart. And now we're seeing Gunvelt charge forward. Maybe over aggressive. Is going to fall back to his team fairly soon. Tactical Visor is actually going to get thrown out by Nil, so can he get anyone? Cresto running extremely low, but Hitman actually drops Nil before he can do so. Gunvelt is going to get nano boosted, and Hitman managed to get one with a pulse bomb. Charging forward, Gunvelt picks up Johnny, and now they're swinging the hammer around as Hitman shows up on the Tracer. Good little grenade, manages to get himself one, and EVH catching the point.
That's painful. That's going to stagger them for quite a while. Falcon Wind does deserve Shatter, and we almost have the Graviton bomb combination ready for Team New Kings here. They're at 42%, so I still give them the edge here, honestly, like just looking at the stats currently.
Yeah, depends how long they can buy this, because if Hitman keeps picking people like Johnny up, now that Graviton surge is down, now that's another couple of seconds where you're lower, and suddenly 20% becomes 30%, 30% becomes 40%, and suddenly EVH actually are the ones with a favorable fight. As I say that, Falcon Wind lands the Earth Shatter onto multiple members. Actually, he can't pick himself up a kill with it though, so ultimate used and not a lot gained, as we're going to see Christo drop Falcon Wind here, and now that advantage is in favor of EVH.
Yeah, and like you said, Johnny being picked off there is also... EVH is good enough to know that when the Zarya is down, they can play so much more aggressively and play into choke points, because what's going to happen?
Oh, there's the Graviton Surge, and the Pulse Bomb is being used. It's only been going to Christo who's going to get picked up by it. So two ultimates expended for two kills, and now it's in the Earth Shatter come from onto Gunvelt, but the Transcendence just completely nullifies anything. Falcon Wind and Nil managed to get themselves a kill. It's a 2-0. Gunvelt running extremely low, does take out Blue Hawk before getting taken out, but now we see the Graviton Surge. Hitman with a triple kill! Nil shows up onto Soulkiller, but that was a fantastic fight for the side of EVH, suddenly turning the tables. The hook goes wide from Zambu. Isn't going to get himself anything else, but what a Graviton Surge and Pulse Bomb combo.
And I was like, are you sure about that Soulkiller? You know, where's the rest of your team? But he didn't need the rest of the team, he just needed Hitman.
And the ultimate's going to get thrown out, a couple there.
With that, that's going to be
the first round
going to Team EVH here.
And EVH got such an advantage. Ooh, hold on. No, they do manage to get themselves a couple of kills. Zambu with a double kill. Blue Hawk trying to buy time. Overtime ticking away. As now it's Nil. Nil's going to go down. Overtime wearing thin. And unfortunately, that is going to be game one. Well, sorry. Yeah. Map one.
Round one.
I guess.
Oh man, the correct nomenclature. No one cares.
I'm not used to these kind of games.
No, that's this is again New Kings, man. Huh? New Kings. They're playing very well. I'd like them to see them get a pick of a map tonight. You know, for starters.
I would like to see that. And even if we don't get that, looking into future games with this team. Obviously, they're relatively new. Yeah, this still is so impressive.
They're still a loser's bracket as well. Like, even if they lose this best of five, they're not out of the tournament by any means.
Yes. And with that, they've got that to work with. Obviously, they're down a map as well. So, yeah, this is kind of where you separate a more experienced team from a less experienced team. How they handle being down. Do they let it get to them, or do they kind of pick themselves up? And the answer to that is no. Asterix takes out Falcon when Zambu gets...
With a bomb grenade.
Sorry, the other way around.
Johnny's just off on his own. Oh, poor monkey.
So yeah, maybe it does get to them. Maybe they do kind of feel a little bit kind of scattered after losing pretty heavily. After if they kind of went in, you get that kind of like, oh wow, we just took EVH down and we just pushed them really hard in, and then suddenly they stamp you. You're like, oh okay. So maybe that kind of gets into your head a little bit. Let's see how they're going to kind of handle that. And maybe, like I was trying to get at before, was leading into later points in the game, into like future series and future seasons. They are an impressive team, and maybe they're someone you want to keep your eye on, but EVH do just kind of walk over them in this team fight, get themselves 5-1.
And that was all thanks to Zambu, right? Like, they didn't do particularly well. Zambu still gets taken out by a charging Falcon. But the only reason why they win that team fight is because Zambu, before he gets charged down, hits a really nice ice barrier. Means that Blue Hawk and Falcon Wind are the only one. It was Blue Hawk and Falcon Wind. Are the only one, on that side of the land. This one doesn't hit as well, though, so it doesn't split the team up, so more stuff might happen here.
Well, we are seeing the Nano Boost come Lucio. Down. It's gonna be a Nano Lucio with a double kill. Fantastic play. Oh man, not who you wanted to click, but you know, he got a double kill on Lucio.
The boosted Lucio.
Man. But now Christo's that much closer to his ultimate, so Sound Barrier is available
sooner.
It's
worth it, man. Crash your tactics.
Yeah, it's secret strats, man.
All jokes aside, with the I'm not entirely sure, are the sensitivity changes in already? Because if they are, then that probably shouldn't happen.
You're the color caster, man. I cast the action. You do the stats and the knowledge. You're asking the wrong guy. I should know this, to be honest. We're heading into 90% to zero here as we see a team fight come through. Gunbelt with a triple kill. Neil's going to drop Asterix, but I don't think it's quite enough at this point. It looks like they're going to look for a few more. Assault Killer takes him out, and Gunbelt gets himself 4 in the overall net of the fight. The Graviton Surge comes through just to buy time, but that is not enough. Oh, 100-0 them on round 2.
Yeah, this is getting progressively more like we expected. Also, I just checked, and yes, it is able to... but like with the PTR, sometimes it's so hard to keep track of, like... You know, especially since they started removing stuff from the PDR as well. You got wind of the Zenyatta changes that were there for like a day.
Yeah.
And Zenyatta was able to use his Discord orb through barriers.
Yeah, that was the most ridiculous thing.
I was so happy with Zenyatta, because I'm like, Zenyatta's my most player. I was like, oh, thank you Blizzard, based Blizz. But then they took it away from the fucking PTR after like a day, and I was like, no, what? But as it was my point being, as a matter of fact, there is you can change your Nano Boost sensitivity, so. Hitting Christy with an Nano Boost shouldn't happen. Doesn't really matter in the grand scheme of things, but I wanted to be, you know, a stickler for details and hash that out regardless.
Once again, Falcon Wind goes down. Soul Killer actually straight away with a double kill. Zarya, one of the most long charging ultimates you can get your hands on, already with 33% on that. As Zambu takes out Neil in 1v1, so not always what you want to see on the side of your soldier getting picked off by a Mei solo. And there it is, EVH on the point, straight off the bat.
Yeah. It kind of gets harder from here on out. Because if you lose this map, you're not just facing EVH, you're also facing yourself. Because like you said, it's going to be kind of a bummer going from, hey, just almost won them up against them, to what is happening, losing.
Just distressing signs. I do really want to kind of point on the fact that I think I don't think they have it in them. I know I'm calling it quite early, but from what we're seeing, I really... Oh, Christo with a triple kill! Oh man, Lucio triples. That is beautiful to see. He's had a double and a triple so far.
playing out of his mind. That's gonna
be ult economy. I was just kind of popping on how they had a massive ult advantage, but Chris did just pop his. Maybe a little bit questionable there. Zambu almost got his. They almost had six ultimates available. Versus just the one on the side of Yuki.
Oh, man. And there we go again. Zambu with the ice.
He's looking for it. Now we're going to see it come through. Looks like the Graviton Surge onto so many targets. The ultimate coming through from Lucio as Johnny and Neil actually manage to get themselves a fight. The Blizzard is thrown out, freezing so many members in place. The Transcendence is there. Neil with a double kill. Zambu trying to find something just by in time with the Ice Wall. The Cap actually is slowly kind of come through on the side of New Kings, and EVH, over aggressive and over confident, actually lose the point.
Yeah, give up a couple of ultimates while they're at it as well. And that was a bit greedy there, using Blizzard in conjunction with a Graviton Surge. You need to be so careful of your ultimate. The enemy, Zayato has that Transcendence. Just because of like what you just saw, there's no way of dealing with enough damage to deal with that.
Massive shout out to multiple members. Falcon Wind is coming through, and that's going to be two kills coming straight through onto New Kings. It looks like Zambu trying to buy time with the Icicle, but you can't cryogenically freeze yourself forever.
You were calling this game, right? Yeah, Brain, am I right? You were like saying, oh, I don't think they have it in them. That's what you were saying, right?
Past the curse, man.
Yeah, man.
These little glimmers of hope coming through from New Kings.
I think Zambu's serious, man.
Oh, wow. We haven't seen Zambu play this in quite a while, and he was a very, very good Reaper, but the Graviton Surge onto so many men. The Earth Shatter comes through from Gundel, keeping them in. That's going to be three kills into favor of EVH. Zambu on the Reaper manages to get himself one, looking for two, but Macarelli manages to pop himself one away as Zambu gets himself a double kill. The Caps did come through in favor of EVH in the long run, and now we're 90% on the clock. I feel like this is probably the map two going in favor of EVH. I say that and then they go crazy over aggressive again.
So close. Yeah, EVH is not really, I mean, it's showing up as in they're winning, but I think we can agree that this is not really what we expected out of them.
This is the triple. Watch this. So many members and he just pops them off. Does he pop them? I thought he did.
There we go.
There we are. Oh.
Hey.
Beautiful. What I'm trying to get back to is how EVH as the team, maybe showing a couple of loose things, but yeah. I want to look at New Kings. They're down two in the series. They've shown so many little glimmers, I hope, and whether or not they lose this series, which kind of looks like that might be the case at this point. I think EVH might get a 3-0 here again.
With how one-sided this one was, yeah. After the first one, I was like, eh.
There was hope, but then, yeah. And we're going on to a payload map onto King's Row as well. New Kings. Like you said, they've got that loser's bracket. So, not the end of the world.
If they lose,
they can go through into that. And I actually think they've got it in them to kind of pull through out of that losers bracket and try and claw themselves up as high as they can. But what I want to look at is the next season. I think they're a potential team who, with enough practice, actually will contest themselves into maybe being a top tier team in next season. I'm calling this extremely early, and I know I am, but
this is kind of my job here. I want to look for New Kings because
they're a team who have shown a lot of promise. Showing some really good team fighting, some really good communication. Yes, they've fallen down to EVH, and EVH have been a consistently good team throughout every game I've ever seen them play. And for them to kind of show up against a team like EVH, like how they have, is within itself fantastic. I'm very excited to see where New Kings will go. I mean, it's not over. They could reverse sweep from this point on, or it's almost not beyond them. They are a really, really good team, and it's not completely beyond them. But
I would say that. Sorry for interrupting you.
No,
I would say that Like, if there is one map where the best team always wins, in my opinion, it feels like it's King's Row. You can't cheese King's Row. Like, it's just too... it just feels like the most, or at least it's my favorite. Not like I love Hanamura and Temple of Anubis and like a lore and general perspective, but if like game design wise, like map design specifically, King's Row is just the best map there is in Overwatch. One of the most iconic ones as well. It's my favorite one at least, and I think it's the best one.
I'm gonna go with Hanamura just because it's so pretty, but I've always kind of found Icon Ward is a very similar layout to King's Row. It feels like they tried to copy what they got out of it. If you actually really look at how the map's laid out, it's kind of like
They're gonna change the first choke of Icon Ward because they felt like it was, it's a little bit too one-sided for their liking, basically.
Well, speaking of one-sided, two kills come from us on the side of EVA. Straight onto the point. That's going to be Asterix taking up Johnny, and Macarelli just going to get bombed in the face. EVH, do you need to... Whoa! Double bomb coming through from Asterix. Hitman's on the sniping there. And, easy cap coming through from EVH.
Yeah. As I was saying, because, this point being taken is pretty obvious. We have a little sniper perch here with Asterix and Hitman just side to side. Shooting people.
So annoying.
Oh, here comes the monkey though.
The monkey has found them, so.
Look at that position.
Anna's actually going to get caught here. No, sleep grenade. Never mind. So annoying.
Yeah. That was so really,
that was
Blue's positioning was really cute there. It was like waiting around the corner for someone to walk into him. But yeah, Eichenwald is the first choke is getting changed somewhat. Jeff Kaplan mentioned that in his AMA, basically, I think.
Soul Killer actually gets nano boosted, and two kills come straight through onto the side of EVH. Actually wasted that ultimate. No, Soul Killer finally picks up Macarelli, but maybe a little bit late on the ulti there. I mean, Hitman's playing really well on the Widowmaker. And as I say that, he highlights that point on the headshot onto Johnny. I think he had his ultimate on, which allowed Asterix to see Blue Hawk around the corner and just sleep him instantly. So I think that's why that worked out. Hitman just takes out Neil. I think Neil popped his ultimate. Yeah, as soon as he popped his ultimate. Now we're seeing the Earth Shatters, two Reinhardts run into each other, but Hitman with a double kill on the Widowmaker. That's actually a triple kill! Turning this really, really well. And now it's in EVH, just push the point through. One more checkpoint. They have 5 minutes and 30 to work with. Yes, this is the hardest point to push, just because you've got extremely short kind of point to push against on the... obviously, the defending team have a spawn very close to the point, and the attacking team have a very long point walk to the point. Either way, 5 minutes and 11 seconds is a lot of time to work with. But Gunvelt
into the enemy spawn and...
Even takes out Asterix, and now we're seeing the Graviton Surge come through on members, pinning them all in place at their spawn. Soulkiller actually managed to get a kill with it. And now we're seeing the sound barrier come out as they're trying to land out the damage as Zambu takes out Neil. Neil takes a switch to the Genji, trying to keep himself going, but they are just walking over them at this point. The Graviton Surge members, this is their opening, but it's going to get wasted. 4 members get dropped on the side of New King. EVH looking for the damages. Christo gets a double kill. Point one goes all the way. EVH have a lot to work with, and New Kings have a lot to work against.
It's always so depressing when they finish the map on King's Row, because you just saw them commit, you know, robot genocide. So it's like, okay. Well, I guess I'm really sorry for you Omnic friends. But... So yeah, it's just like, okay. Well, that's awkward.
Didn't they have a Zenyatta there? When you're pushing a Zenyatta.
Yeah, one of them was playing. I think that the one of them was playing Zenyatta at least. It's like, oh, okay. Well then, it's unfortunate. little jokes aside, Orisa's really cool, by the way. Like design, I'm really psyched for when she gets into when she's like loaded into. Have you read up on her? Because she's a really.
I have read up on her. I'm holding my tongue about her because when Sombra came out, I said she'd be game-changing, and I was 100% wrong on that.
Yeah, I mean, she might be.
I horribly admit, because I was like, wow, that ultimate can die deactivate Reinhardt shields, it can take out turrets, it can take out all this, sound barriers are nothing, it's meta changing, and then actually no one played her.
She didn't do anything. But she's getting buffed as well, so
yes.
Blizzard obviously agrees with you that she should be able to do more. However, I really like the fact that they're doing very well, I feel, with Blizzard's currently doing very well, you know, considering that Anna was kind of a, she does everything extremely well. With Orisa, it feels a little bit more balanced, and she provides some roles that, you know, somewhat like Reinhardt is only as well. It's kind of cool.
See how this is going to work out. EVH only have to defend for 4 minutes. Yeah,
that's it. Point one defense.
That's all they have to do.
That's what they're going for, I reckon.
I honestly think that's their goal at this point. I think if they were 100% serious about it, Symmetra, just so they get the teleports or the shields, but gonna stick to what they know, and it has been working out for them. So, who am I? DK has come out straight away, gets himself a kill.
No, I'm not able to hit anyone yet.
This is just fantastic play coming through. We're seeing Blue Hawk actually pick Genji. See how this is going to work out for him. Obviously looking to get those flanks on. Has quite a lot to work against here. As we're seeing, deciding New King's actually spread apart here. Johnny's behind the team alone, as Falcon Wind has got Macarelli behind him. And you're seeing them getting punished heavily for the fact they got split apart so hard there. Two kills coming through straight away as Gunbelt actually does finally take someone out. Gunbelt does finally get taken out by Blue Hawk there. And now Blue Hawk looking to try and get himself on the point, but I don't know if he's going to be able to hold it for too long. He has got Neil at his back, but the whole team of EVH are coming through. And EVH, you can't deflect shield, the cannon from
Zarya. EVH's movement as a team is something I really like. It's something that I feel like when they're playing well like this, they're doing better than most other teams. Look at how focused as a unit they are. Like when they can afford to be, because there's no Graviton Surge anywhere near. The Blue Hawk has his ultimate though, so I imagine this is going to be a playmaking opportunity for him.
He's either going to fall over or carry the fight. Let's see how he's going to play out. Look where he is, he's got that high ground. Just trying to be a bit of a nuisance at the moment. I think he's waiting for Zambu to throw the hook out. Once the hook's down, then he knows he can kind of go in.
That's a good play. Very, very...
tempered.
Yeah, exactly. I really like Blue Hawk's play this series so far.
And you said keep your eye on him, and I mean, I understand exactly why you're saying that, but let's have a quick look at the ultimates now. Three ultimates on the side of EVH, three on the side of New Kings. I think we're going to have an explosive fight any second now. Zambu picks up Blue Hawk, so that is just buying time. You don't want to fight 4v5, so now New Kings have to wait for...
New Kings is just going to go for six ultimates and then try to... Oh, never mind, they're not.
That's it, the sound barrier is going to get thrown out. Earth Shatter lands onto a couple of members. That's going to be Hitman with a double kill. Christo picks himself up once, that's a 3-0. That's going to be Hitman with a triple kill on the soldier. And team fight done. Couple of ultimates expended. Still got their Earth Shatter, still got their sound barrier. Almost got the whole hog as well.
I mean, yeah, they have Earth Shatter and Graviton Surge. And almost have the whole.
Yeah.
The Graviton Surge, like if Aklaxis plays this well, he can carry the next team fight, right? If they're baited into using some ultimates here.
If they play it well, they've gone into the hotel. Earth Shatter's gonna come down. That's two kills in favor of EVH straight off the bat. That's gonna be the whole hog. Double kill onto Zambu. Soul Killer gets himself one. You see Blue Hawk run himself onto the point, but unfortunately, it's not enough.
And that's what I was referring to, right? Because that's really hard. But if, as Senyata, you're able to like make something happen, that it's so good. If they use the Earth Shatter and just, you know, are able to deal with your team, just gets into a good position. But wasn't meant to. Nell picks off Asphyx though. Maybe this is the opening that they needed. Immediately they go in.
That's pretty big. They do get that opening. I do like the switch. Let's see whether or not Genji's Dragonblade will get drawn. Obviously, the Graviton Surge is going to get thrown out. That's the Transcendent. Just negating the ultimate coming through from Soul Killer as Dragonhawk manages to. Blue Hawk, sorry. Manages to get him one. Actually, didn't use his ultimate, so he's still holding on to it. And the cap is slowly coming through. Asterix is back, and he has Hitman at his back as well, but it's just Falcon winning him. Neil, Christo, all fighting out on the back line here. Time's a ticking away. Gunbelt needs to get himself onto the point, but the Earth Shatter's there. Gonna pop him back. Nilwyn's gonna get himself one. Asprey takes that Nil straight off the back as the overtime is ticking away. Falconwood, three kills come through. That's gonna be four. The sound barrier's coming out. Hitman with three. That's your Falconwood left. I think it might be the Quadra coming through. No, Zambu picks him up. Overtime ticking away. And EVH take the 3-0 over New Kings.
Like the story of this, like I don't want it to feel like we're just, you know, hyping up boring games. But what you said earlier, I really agree. Like, look how decisive.